Namaste. Welcome to Geeta's Kitchen. Today, day 2 of Navratri. Our prasadam is moong dal, split yellow moong dal sundal. I am going to make appam and lemon rice. So first, I have kept the moong dal for cooking in the pressure cooker. Meanwhile, we can do with the other things. I have also soaked 1 cup of rice for about 2 hours now. Drain out this water. You soak it for a longer time also, no problem. Okay, now we'll take the soaked rice in your blender jar. Add a little bit of water and grind it to a smooth fine paste. 1 whistle over, I am switching it off. Coming back to our mixie, see the rice has been ground to a smooth paste. At this stage, add an equal quantity of jaggery to it and again grind it together once more. Just remember, don't add too much water while grinding the rice, then your batter will become very watery. Or you can even grind the jaggery and the rice together also. Always add less water. See, this should be the consistency, more or less like idli batter. I'm just adding a pinch of cardamom powder to this, and I have a few pieces of cashew nut which I have broken and kept. I'll add that also. Now mix it very well. You can make this with ghee because you are giving it as a prasad. Or if you don't want, you can use oil, or you can use a mixture of oil and ghee, whatever suits you. Pour some batter, spoonfuls of batter into this, into each mold. While the appams are getting done, see, our dal is also ready. So we can now just drain out the water from the dal to keep it ready for the sundal. I am keeping the rice for the lemon rice. Now this one side is done. We can turn it over and cook the other side also like this. Are done and ready, you can remove it like this. Likewise, you do with the remaining batter also. So now I have got about 7 in one batch. I think totally we can get about 20 to 25 appams out of 1 cup of rice. For the moong dal sundal, you just take about 3 teaspoons of oil. After removing this moong dal, I have kept the rice in the same cooker for making the lemon rice. So this way, by multitasking, you can save a lot of time and complete your work easily. Some mustard seeds, urad dal, 2 to 3 green chilies, a few curry leaves, little bit of hing, when the dals are brown, add this boiled dal to it. See, this split moong dal, you need not soak overnight, unlike the whole grams. This you can just soak for an hour, that is enough. Salt to taste. Mix it well. Finally, add this freshly grated coconut to it. Mix the coconut well together. See, the dal is now separate and nice. Switch it off and finally add lemon juice. You can squeeze the juice of 1 lemon and add to it. and your day 2 sundar, moong dal sundar is ready to be served as a prasadam. Now for the third naivedyam, we are making lemon rice. We had cooked the rice earlier. Now I have kept it for cooling, and while cooling, you can just add 1 or 2 teaspoons of oil to it and keep it aside. For the tempering, heat about a tablespoon of oil, some mustard seeds, urad dal, chana dal, just 1 dry red chili, a few ground nuts, curry leaves and ginger, and here I have some chopped green chili. A little bit of hing to this, and also some haldi powder. Saute them till the nuts are also nice and crisp. Now pour this onto your rice. Take some salt in a bowl and squeeze the lemon juice into it. And pour this on top of the rice. Now mix everything well together with a gentle hand. So our naivedyam for day 2 of Navratri, which is Sunday, 18th of October, being Sunday again, it is for Surya Devata and of course Devi Ma also. So the traditional North Indian naivedyam is this shakkar. Shakkar meaning this jaggery powder or country sugar, you can call it, and appam, sweet appam, and of course the typical traditional sundal made with moong dal. Next we listen to the day 2 story of Devi Saptashati.
Sarvamangala Mangalye Shive Sarvata Sadake Sharanye Triambake Gauri Narayani Namostate.
By the grace of Ma Durga, we are now starting out on the day 2 story of Devi Saptashati. The day 2 story deals with the killing of Mahishasura. All of you must have heard of the story of Mahishasura and also the famous stotram Aigiri Nandini, about the Mahishasura Mardini Stotram also, that was composed by Adi Shankara. Now this Mahishasura was a great demon king, and all these asuras, they used to do a lot of tapas and then get a boon, and with which, after getting that boon, they used to terrorize all the devas and people in all the worlds. So this asura, after getting his boon, he started troubling the devas a lot, and the fight between Mahishasura, who was the king of the asuras, and Indra, the king of the devas, went on for about 100 years, and the devas then knew no way of winning the battle. Then with Brahma as the leader, they go to Shiva, and also to, and all of them go again to Mahavishnu and plead, please help us to find a way out. Mahishasura is terrorizing us and troubling us too much. Mahisha Asura. Asura is a demon. Mahisha is the head of a buffalo, a demon with a buffalo head. That is why he is called as Mahishasura. Then both Shiva and Vishnu become very angry at this, and then they, with their power, the light of their power, they create a female form, and so, and all the devas also give their light to that form. So through Shiva she gets her face, through Vishnu she gets her arms, Brahma's light becomes her feet, Indra's light becomes her waist, and so on, and a beautiful Shakti is formed over there. And apart from this, everybody gives her their weapons too. Shiva gives her his Trishul, Vishnu gives her his chakra, that is the discus, and is told that Kala, the god of time, gives her a sword and shield, and Kubera, the lord of wealth, he gives her a drinking cup which will always be ever full and never go empty. And the milky ocean gives her a necklace made of undecaying jewels. And she looks so beautiful and brilliant, dazzling, and also with all these armor in her hand. And she laughs aloud. It is called as Attahasa. That kind of a laughter, it's a mighty roar. It makes all the worlds tremble. Then the devas and the rishis, they become very happy. And they sing praises of Devi, saying, Jaya Jaya Devi, victory to you, victory to you. Because now they feel this Devi can achieve a victory for the devas. Remember, Mahishasura had a boon that he could not be killed by anybody except a lady. He said, what can a woman do to me? That is why Devi takes the form of a woman and proceeds towards the killing of Mahishasura. When Mahishasura heard about this, he is wondering what has happened, and he goes there to see the great Devi present, who has bent the earth with her feet. Her crown is tearing the sky, and the roaring sound which she emanates becomes like makes the whole world tremble with fear. And then she has started fighting with the generals of the Asuras, and she starts killing all of the Asura generals and the Asura army one by one. Seeing the Asura army, the generals, everybody destroyed in no time, the rishis and the devas, they become very pleased and sing praises of her and shower petals on her. Next is the third chapter. The third chapter deals with the killing of Mahishasura. Now that his army is destroyed, Mahishasura himself comes forward to battle with Devi. And he has come with a buffalo form, and with his hooves he tramples the earth, with his horns he uproots mountains and hurls all of them at Devi. And seeing this great anger of Mahishasura, Devi is really very upset and in a rage, and she also starts fighting, and a terrible battle ensues. And when she starts fighting, Mahishasura changes his form. First he appears in a buffalo form, and then when she hurls stones at him, she changes into the form of a lion. Then Devi throws a noose around him to catch the lion, and he quickly changes into a human form, and he fights with Devi using a sword and a shield. And when Devi is fighting with him in a human form, again he changes his mind and he changes back into a buffalo form. And this kind of fighting goes on for a very long time. And then Devi is getting very angry, and here Mahishasura is also intoxicated with rage. And you remember that cup which Devi has? So she drinks from that cup, you know, as a small respite between this battle. And then she finds Mahishasura roaring wildly. And then Devi says, I'll just read out those two lines to you. She says, Garja garja kshanam muda madhu yavat pibamyaham tvayi hatraiva garjishyatyashu devata. Oh, you stupid fool Mahishasura, go on roaring and shouting as much as you want, because it's only for a kshanam, very small minuscule amount of time that you are going to roar now. Soon I am going to destroy you, you will be killed. And all the devas will now do their roaring in terms of praise and happiness at your being killed. Having said this, Devi then pounces on the Asura, holds his throat firmly with her foot, and then chops off his head, and half of his body emerges, half of his form emerges from his body, and Devi kills him. Now all the devas are very pleased and they sing the praise and victory of Devi. Now what does this really mean? Again, coming back to it, now the killing of Mahishasura refers to the killing of our Rajoguna. In the first story, killing of Madhu and Kaitava referred to the destruction of our Tamoguna. Rajoguna represents the arrogance coming out of our various desires. So Mahishasura, assuming various forms, first he comes as a buffalo, then he changes himself to a lion, then into a human form, and then again into a buffalo form. What does it really mean? That when one desire crops up, that is fulfilled, then what does our mind do? We go frantically after the next desire, and then the next one, and then the next one. We keep changing our mind, running behind desire after desire, and then that also fills our mind. When the desire is not fulfilled, we get anger, and then anger leads to a total destruction, both mentally and physically also. In the Bhagavad Gita also, this is what Krishna tells Arjuna, that the main cause of man's downfall is kama and krodha. Kama yeti, krodha yeti. These are the two things Krishna says. So this story of Mahishasura really tells us to destroy the rajoguna present in us, which should stop us from getting unduly angry, and because of anger we are not able to control our mind. Many times we say things we do not want to say, or we perform certain actions which maybe we might repent later. So controlling your anger, controlling your running after desires, controlling your feelings when your particular desire is unfulfilled, and then that should not lead on to anger, but then you should be content. Okay, this is what is for me today, let me accept it gratefully. So that is the story of the killing of Mahishasura. Thank you for watching the video. We'll meet again tomorrow in day 3 of Navaratri with the Navaratri Prasadam and the story of day 3 of the Devi Mahatmya. Jai Jai Shankara, Hara Hara Shankara.